So I've hair dried this off equally across the page like this. And where it was a little bit waterlogged, I've used the tissue or a cloth to just blot up some of the images. Just put the hair dryer on by mistake. I think this is quite interesting. I can definitely see this foot here. And there's something happening here and a head here. So I'm going to take a very fine piece of charcoal, but you could at this point take a black fine liner as long as that chalk isn't going to clog it up too much. You could either take a very fine paintbrush and you could start working into this. But I'm going to start pulling out some areas. Try to resist the urge to put a definite head shape in there, okay? Unless you particularly like the look of the profile, try not to fix anything. These marks and lines that we have on the paper are possibilities. And when you fix it and you make it too strong, you're almost limiting your possibilities. That's how I look at that. So I'm trying to make sense of this image, and I'm looking at the marks that I have on this paper that's been created from the charcoal, then from the water, and then from the ink, and seeing is there any interesting marks that suggest movement. Dancing. Love this area. Sometimes the areas that I don't know what they are going to be, ooh, they're often the most exciting. So when I get to an area where I think, why is that not coming together? Why is that not working? I then tell myself, ah, you're hiding, are you? You're being mysterious. Okay, that's going to be one of the really exciting areas. And that's how I do it. I just big myself up. I talk myself up. I don't allow that insecure voice inside of me to say, you can't do it, it's rubbish, it's not working. I just trust myself as an artist, as a creative, that I will find a way to make this image work.